So you are
No,
trying to
broadly,
turn India from a thali to a saffron
let me
khichdi.
take it from there. Let me take it from there. See, broadly, the description he gave about India from a pilot to the president of India, nobody has any dispute. It happened under every regime. We made Abdul Kalam the president of India. But that doesn't mean we made means that we followed India's constitutional, not only constitutional, age-old tradition of Sarva Dharma Samabha. We don't discriminate on the basis of religion. That has been the core of Indian thinking. Now, we should give up smugness that we know Atma Santushti, that we have read constitution, nobody else has read constituent assembly debates. May I ask a simple question? When the constituent assembly debates happened, I am sure he must have read all the 3,000 pages. In the constituent assembly debates happened, some people wanted reference to God. Mm-hmm. We should have reference to God. It was rejected. Some people wanted this word secularism to be inserted. That was also rejected. I'm sure Mr. Tharoor has read the entire constituent assembly debates.
Yes, yes.
Both were rejected. So don't have smugness that I have not read. I have also read. So point is, then why was it decided that we don't need the word secularism in the constitution? Because Jawaharlal Nehru himself had on record said, you please refer to constituent assembly debates. He says, India is a very diverse country. We have to respect all the different traditions, practices, cultures, customs. You can't just say that we have to be away from religion and customs here. That is why there is no need. In any case, India has always respected all religions. You don't need to insert secularism into our constitution specially. India is secular by character. That character is Hindu character, we are saying. You say, no, that's not Indian Hindu character, Indian character. I don't have an issue. But don't say that India has secularism only because constitution has given us that idea. No, it did not give us in 1947. It was backdoor insertion during emergency in 1976 by Indira Gandhi. Even then, we don't have any dispute. Let secularism prevail in this country but in its right sense. What is the secularism that you practice? You want people to be secular. You ran governments which are thoroughly communal. You made acts on communal lines. And you are teaching secularism to the whole country. You are saying Hindu Rashtra is communal. By the most liberal idea which even constituent assembly, makers of constituent assembly admitted that this country by very character is secular. There is no need for that word to be inserted in constitution. That is the idea of India to which we are wedded. So that idea, which we want to uphold, you may have dispute on individual issues. That's no problem. Let me tell you, I have an issue with constituent assembly debates. I would like to hear what is your comment. The entire constituent assembly debates, the draft constitution that has come out, from there to this day, they do not refer India as one nation, do you know? The preamble says, we, the people of India. First article, Article 1 of the Constitution, describes India as a union of states, not nation. And not that this was not discussed. Ambedkar, in his last speech, let me give my gyan of Constituent Assembly also. Ambedkar, in his last speech, tells the Constituent Assembly that, see, people told me that why are you aping America? Why are you calling beginning Indian constitution by saying we the people of India, because the United States constitution begins with this statement, we the people of United States of America. Ambedkar said, people told me, call it we the nation of India, or the we the Indian nation. But I refuse to accept that amendment, that suggestion, because we are yet not a nation. This was Ambedkar's view at that time, which prevailed. Did we contest it? Ambedkar had a point. He said, this consciousness of nationhood is missing. The word he used was nationhood is a spiritual idea. Now, spiritual, as per his definition, is anti-secular. It's a spiritual idea, friends. That was missing. Ambedkar said, we are too much into caste, too much into language, too much into regions. That has to go. A spiritual idea of national consciousness should grow in this country. This constitution will strive towards that. We are wedded to that constitution of constituent assembly, fathers of our constituent assembly, not the new interpretations of it.
Dr. Tharoor,
I don't think there's any disagreement there. I mean, the point is, everything Ram has said, I'm not disagreeing with. Correct. But as long as we both converge on that interpretation, one of the challenges is this use of Hindutva and the use of a religious identity as a marker of Indianness. That is where the problem comes, because it by default excludes those who, for whatever reason, historical accident, whatever you want, do not fit into that label. I mean, there are Christians in my state of Kerala who have been Christian for longer than most Hindu families have been conscious of their Hinduism. There are people of every faith in our country who have contributed to the building of the Indian nation and who have as much of a right to be stakeholders in it as those who consider themselves Hindus, as you and I do. So the point is that as long as we recognize that, then a pernicious term that excludes those who do not subscribe to one particular religion should also be avoided.
Otherwise,
I have no disagreement with what you said.
No question of any, that's what I'm saying. The original Hindu idea of this country never excludes anybody. That's the reason why even the makers of Indian constitution felt there is no need to specially insert secularism in our constitution, because we are by character, by nature, the whole edifice of the society is very secular. When Mahatma Gandhi described himself as a Sanatani Hindu, was he a communal Hindu? Read, I mean, not just 3,000 pages of draft constitution, constituent assembly debates. If you read Discovery of India, how Nehru describes India was purely cultural terms, religious terms. It's another matter. We introduced this false debate in 70s, starting with 70s, because we needed to curb the rise of an alternative ideology in this country. It was rising from 70s onwards. So we invented a new controversy that you are not secular. Your Hindutva is communal. You are exclusivist. We are saying no. We are that Hindutva which reflected in the draft first constitution of India, which carried the photographs of Rama, Krishna, Bhagavad Gita. That is what we stand for.